Recently, my boss, Bernie Brooks, controversially lamented that dealing with shareholders is like herding cats. Well, Geoff Garrett, who's managed top-level academic and research institutions, can relate. He's found researchers, like cats, seek to exercise as much independence as possible. Sky News business reporter Donna Sawyer spoke with Mr. Garrett about the book and his apt analogy.
Cats cannot be commanded and can choose their owner. And that is the sort of people that we've been dealing with, Graeme Davies, my colleague and I, for all our working lives. You're dealing with highly sophisticated, highly intelligent, often argumentative, independent spirits that often want to go their own way, and leading and managing in that environment is often referred to as herding cats. It's a difficult task, but a very challenging and rewarding one.
Your book deals with common management challenges, many of which could be applied to business. What are some of the most important aspects of being a good manager?
Well, I think in our environment, and in any environment, you're absolutely correct. I think there's a number of the people that we consulted, because we consulted 50 of our colleagues around the world in senior positions, both in academia, research, and business. And there are a number of common themes. And I think one of the other points to make is that we're dealing with knowledge workers here, which is much of the economy, particularly going forward. And we felt one of the common themes was around the importance of setting big goals, because, you know, inspiring people about where we're going and what we're going to achieve, and scientists and engineers and researchers really like to be pushed, but also to be pushed in a direction that they can see great advantage. One of our colleagues from a major research establishment in the US was saying, he's in Silicon Valley, he said there's good news and bad news about being in Silicon Valley. The good news is it's replete with talent. The bad news is that unless we're working on something exciting and challenging and rewarding, they'll go elsewhere. So setting those big goals that inspire and challenge people, I think, is a very key important aspect in the first instance.
You say the art of recruiting the right people is critical, a million-dollar decision. What do you mean by that?
What we mean is, and again, a core theme, whether it's in our environment or in the business environment, is that all business is people business. Managing a big university or a big research organisation today, you know, you're approaching a $1 billion business with all the complexity associated with that, and a workforce that perhaps is slightly different, particularly from a cultural dimension, from normal business. So we're saying that talent is key, and if you can inspire that talent and challenge that talent and provide them with the tools to be the best they can be, then you're going to be successful. So what we mean by that is, when you're hiring the best, you need to put a lot of time and effort and enthusiasm and different perspectives into that process. Too often we take people on without actually having due diligence into that process. And if you get those hiring decisions wrong, very often it's your fault, not the person's fault. And it's, you know, we have one of our sayings is, the people with the best people win, you know, whether you're playing rugby or cricket or whether you're in the research and academic environment. So it's how do you identify those people with enthusiasm and judgment and excellence at their core. And that takes time and energy.
You talk a lot in the book about making tough strategic choices. What advice would you give to someone in a leadership role about that?
I think too often, you know, what we say is strategies around choice. It's saying we're going to do that, we're going to do that, but we're not going to do this and we're not going to do that. It's around putting yourself in the future and saying, what is the future we're trying to create, and rolling back from that future, as opposed to this is where we are at the moment, where we want extrapolating forward from that. And you can't be all things to all men. You have to, and women, you have to make choices. So it's around focus. We also talk about focus, focus, focus. It's about saying, this is the vision we're trying to create. These are these big goals, and these are the handful of things that we need to concentrate on.
Managers should network, because it's lonely at the top.
Very. I think many of our colleagues around the world and ourselves were sort of surprised that when you have the responsibility for leading an organisation, who do you talk to? You can talk at home, of course, but having people that are friends and colleagues in similar situations to act as sounding boards and to creatively work from each other in terms of what works and what the problems you're confronting, and most importantly, how you work together across institutions. You know, we're great believers in in creating teams and teams of institutions. You know, in my business, the science innovation business, many of the exciting innovations happen at these strange interfaces between disciplines and between institutions. So creating an environment where you can really work with leaders in other environments and say, crikey, if we were only holding hands, 1 + 1 = 3 or 4 or 5. And you can also, you know, be sounding boards to each other about the day-to-day challenges. So that networking is very important. A, doing your job, and B, helping you as a leader and learning from each other.